Today we're going to talk about some major changes that are coming to federal student loan servicers and how that could potentially impact you. So if you have federal student loans, you're going to want to keep watching this video. Hey Wealth Builders, what is up? It's Akiva and welcome back to another episode of The Bemuse, where we are making sense of all things money for young adults just like me. So if you're into that kind of stuff, go on ahead and hit that big red subscribe button. And while you're at it, hit the notification bell so that you never miss when we post new valuable content, just like this video that you're about to watch. So before we even get into it, let's clarify what a student loan servicer is for those of you who are not familiar. So if you have federal student loans, your loan is held by the Department of Education, but they partner with different servicers. They have like 8 or 9 servicers that they use that actually administer the loans. So when you make your payments, you're making your payments to your student loan servicer for your federal student loans. They are the people that you would call if you ever had questions about your account, about your payments, about your payment plan, getting that changed. That is your student loan servicer. So who your student loan servicer is can be a major deal depending on, you know, different levels of customer service and different things that you might experience being with one servicer versus another. Now, we've talked about the importance of student loan servicers in the past and how to find out who yours is. And if you missed that video, it's one of the early videos we did on our channel. I'll make sure to put a card right up here so that after this video, you can go check that out and figure out how to even determine who your loan servicer is in the first place, because that's going to be a really important piece of information for you to know going through this video and talking about all these changes that are happening. So what's happening with my student loan servicer and why do I care? So here's what's going on. So back in June, the Department of Education announced that they were doing a major overhaul of their student loan servicing system. So they talked about 5 companies that they signed contracts with in order to service student loans going forward. It seems like these are the 5 companies that are really going to be taking over the majority of student loans out there. And those 5 companies are Ed Financial Services, FH Can and Associates LLC, Maximus Federal Services Inc., Mohila, which is an existing student loan servicer already, and Trellis Company, which is also known as the Texas Guaranteed Student Loan Corporation. So these are the 5 companies that the Department of Education has said that they have signed new contracts with to really take over the servicing of their loans. And the argument with this change is that they think it will lead to greater accountability for student loan servicers, which has been an issue for many in the past, complaining about, you know, consistency with applying payments and making sure things are done according to the way they're supposed to be done, customer service variances, etc. And that's pretty important because you want to make sure that no matter who your student loan servicer is, whoever your loans are assigned to, you're getting the same treatment whether you're with one company or with another. What this also means is that there are a couple of student loan servicers whose contracts have not been renewed. And those include Great Lakes and Nelnet. Ironically, those are the 2 student loan servicers that I deal with personally. So that means eventually my loans are going to be transferred from these 2 agencies to one of the 5 that I mentioned earlier. And that change is going to impact millions of student loan borrowers just like me. Now, the current servicing contracts were originally set to expire on December 14th of 2020. However, in August, after that June release when they talked about these changes, they came out and basically clarified and said that this isn't going to be, you know, an immediate change in the future. It's going to take some time to get these companies ramped up and get everybody on the same page. And so there won't be an immediate change in the servicing for Great Lakes and Nelnet. They then indicated that the contracts for Great Lakes, Nelnet, Navient, and Fed Loan Servicing were extended through December of 2021. So for those of you who have federal student loans with those agencies, you shouldn't, emphasis on shouldn't, see any changes until then. But I'm gonna tell you about a quick switch up that happened the other day that is really why this video is being made and why we shouldn't just, you know, take that at face value. So we should be safe until December 2021 before anything changes. And the contracts for Granite State, Ed Financial, Mohila, and OSLA Servicing were extended through March of 2022. So if your loans are with those servicers, you should, again, should be safe until March of 2022. Now, another company that was originally part of these contract extensions was Cornerstone. However, a couple of weeks ago, Cornerstone's contract was abruptly terminated, like effective ASAP. So now we have over 1 million student loan borrowers who are now going through the process right now of having their loans transferred from Cornerstone. In this case, they're all being transferred to Fed Loan Servicing, from what I understand. Now, Cornerstone blamed this abrupt decision on continuing losses, blah, 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 blah. I don't really know or care what the reason is. What we care about is, how does this change affect us as student loan borrowers, and what should you be doing during this time? So when your federal student loans get transferred to another servicer, there are some important questions and things you should stay abreast of and stay on top of. In terms of your monthly payments and your due dates, those should not change. Your monthly payment should be the same. They should theoretically be transferring all of the data over from one servicer to the other. Your due date should still stay the same. Your monthly payment should still stay the same. However, there are some things that you'll want to do once your loans get transferred over to your new servicer. If you had automatic debit, for example, coming out of a bank account paying your monthly bill, you're gonna wanna set that up with your new servicer. It's not gonna automatically transfer over. So if that's you and you wanna make sure that that's set up, make sure you do so that you don't end up missing payments, especially in this crucial time where there's no mandatory payments. When that repayment hits in January, which is right around the corner, you don't wanna be stuck with a missed payment or things like that just because you forgot to set up your new direct debit from your account if your loans are getting transferred right now. Also, if you signed up for paperless billing with your servicer, that's something you're gonna wanna double check once your loans get transferred, so you don't get a bunch of mail and stuff that you don't really need that you're gonna immediately toss. Now, if you accidentally send a payment to your prior servicer, they should be forwarding that information over to the new servicer. However, those things, of course, take time, so you just want to make sure that you stay in connection with both agencies, let them know what's going on. More contact is always better than none, especially during these changes, so they don't say that you missed a payment when in fact it went to the other agency by mistake. Another important thing is when it comes to tax documents. Specifically, the form 1098E, which is the form that shows how much student loan interest you paid for the calendar slash tax year. So many servicers will only report the amount of interest that you paid while your loans were administered through that servicer. So for example, if you were with Cornerstone for most of the year, you made some payments, during this year, and now your loans are being transferred over to Fed Loan Servicing, you might end up getting two 1098Es, one from Cornerstone, one from Fed Loan Servicing, if you do make payments, before the year is over, which many might not, but some might. So you just wanna make sure that when it's time to file your taxes and you're getting the right documentation, you just make sure that it's looking right from both places. Just don't be surprised if you end up getting two instead of one. And the 1098E is only required if you pay $600 or more in interest. So it's also totally possible that you might only get one from one or the other or none if you really haven't been making payments all year. So you just wanna make sure that you're keeping track on your own of how much interest you've paid, looking on your account, because you may not get a tax form to claim that. And you paid the money, if you're entitled to a tax deduction because of it, you wanna make sure that you get all that money. The other huge thing you should do right now is, before your loans get transferred, document everything. Like, take screenshots of like every page you can when you sign into your account. Every single loan number, loan balance, payment history, get all of the data you can. Literally everything. And that might sound like overkill, but trust me, you'll be glad that you have it, because sometimes mistakes happen. Things do not get transferred over properly, and you want to make sure that you have your back covered in case they're saying your balance is X when you know it to be Y. So go in now while you still have access, document everything, download everything, all of your history, all of your payments, take note of your interest rates, your disbursement dates, your origination fees, everything, just like anything you can get your hands on. Get that information in your hands now so you can compare it once your loans get transferred over to make sure that everything went over correctly and you don't run into any issues. So let me know in the comments if any of you guys were affected by this specific change that just happened with Cornerstone moving all the loans over to Fed Loan Servicing. Let me know how that process is going, if that affected you. I know one person personally who that happened to, and they're in the process and getting emails from their servicers and letting them know what they need to do. So if you are in that predicament, let me know in the comments so you can share best practices, tips, stories with those of us who may be going down that same road further down the line. So I hope this video was helpful for you guys. Leave your thoughts and comments down below. You guys know we like to respond to every single comment as much as possible, so chat with us down there. If you haven't subscribed yet, go on ahead and hit that subscribe button so you can join the squad and learn all things about money that we like to share around here. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video.